Good morning to everyone. Good morning to everyone. It's a Saturday morning and really grateful to have all of you here with us for our morning session. We actually do have two sessions in the morning and one more, which is a Chinese session in the afternoon. So if you do feel that you want to look at more ideas and more recipes, you can also join us in the afternoon. All right, so let me start. We do have some new viewers today. First time to Thermomix demo. Do we have that in our audience today, in our participants? Can I know if you are first time into our Zoom demo?
Yes, I'm first time. My name is Nina.
Good to have you, Nina. Great to have you.
I'm a first time as well. Daniel here.
Daniel, okay. Because it's good that I know that I would really do a more in-depth, thorough explanation about the functions and the purpose of the Thermomix for you.
Yeah, I have ordered my machine, but it's not here yet. So the agent sent me this link, so I want to see how this thing works, actually. A bit nervous.
So the session, you would really want to get your hands on the machine as soon as possible.
Okay. Yeah.
Great. So just stay with us. If you have any questions, just type in the chat room. And we have a number of partners here who will be able to address your inquiries. Yeah, and that will be giving you a lot of ideas when you get your machine that gets you started easily and fast. All right. So, okay, we are here. So to all of you, actually, I started exploring the Thermomix like everyone. I was seeing how my friend cooked. And I said, wow, Thermomix is wonderful. And I would like to explore more. And then I got invited into a demo. Right? And this was my journey as well, just like everyone. Okay? So with that time, cooking for me was important because I wanted to start cooking for my family, for my children, right? And I didn't start early. I started only at 36, 37. So I wish I had done it earlier. So when I explored the Thermomix, I was like, yes, you know, it's something that I can do. But now in current pandemic, right, cooking now is like, really a must, right? Home cooking is really, really important at home. And for some of you who do cook, plan to cook at home, what would be the things that you would be looking out for? Right? Would you like to cook like restaurant quality food, right? If you can, it's like, wow, if I can bring that kind of recipes and I can be able to do it at home, how wonderful would that be, right? So Thermomix is able to help you to do that because it is so easy that it gives you the confidence that yes, and when doing that, you realize, oh, in the long run, you really do save a lot of money, okay? The other thing that a lot of people look at are easy recipes because only when it's easy, you would want to get your hands on it because all of us are really, really, you know, busy with our life, with our work, with children, everything. So you will be able to realize that, well, Thermomix can help you easily, you know, make your cooking really fast and simple at home. All right, healthy eating, which is very important now. Healthy, we talk about safety as well. Healthy, we talk about ingredients that we want in our food. And that's the only way that you can control if you cook at home, right? If you eat out or even if you order from outside, there's no way you can control what ingredients is included in the food. Yeah, so this is what we call healthy eating. And if that's important to you, you know, this will be a wonderful way for you to cook at home. Creative cooking, we talk about what to eat every day. Do you have that problem? Thinking about, well, what should I cook today? What should I eat today? Even eating out, right? Now, Thermomix, the great news is that we have 67,000 recipes and it's still being added on. 67,000, can you imagine if you cook 10 recipes a day? You wouldn't be able to finish all the recipes in a lifetime. So you have food like Asian recipes, like ranging from as detailed as Malay recipes, Chinese recipes, Indonesian, and then you would want like a specialty like Thai, you know, it's all there for you to explore. And you want to go abroad further to European recipes, like the Italian, you know, it's all there. So you just search, you know, Cookidoo 67,000 recipes, and then you're able to replicate those recipes at home yourself. And you talk about time saving, right? This is what is very important to us. And you realize that, well, with Thermomix, you do save a lot of time in cleaning, in prepping, in cooking, you know, and everything. And at the end of the cooking, you really have nothing much to clean except the Thermomix itself, right? Okay. So if you're new, of course, you would look at the quality of the product that you will be acquiring. So whatever you buy, you will look into, oh, is it a good quality? Is it something that has been around for some time that is proven? Is it something that would be able to give me quality after-sales service, right? Ensure that I really use my machine. And I would like to share this piece of news that Thermomix has been around. It's under Forwec. So the company Forwec has been around for 130 years, right? Very well established. We have 80 over branches all over the world, different countries, 80 over countries all over the world. And in over the many years, we have also accumulated multiple international awards and recognition. So this is how strong the moment is. So for some, maybe you think that, hey, is it really a new product? Because I just heard about it. I just realized it's something like that. I would like to bring you to the history of the Thermomix. It started since 1960 until now. This is the latest version, which is the TM6. So you could see that, you know, we have been evolving for many, many years. Until today, it is still the all-in-one, the number one all-in-one kitchen machine. Every 23 seconds, you realize that, oh, my friend is using, oh, another family is using the Thermomix, right? Okay, so this is how strong and reliable this product is. Okay, let's discover a little bit about what comes with the Thermomix. How does it look like? Because for some, they think that, you know, you can do cakes, you can do breads, you can do ice cream, and then next minute, you can do your rendang, you can saute your vegetables, and then you can do sous vide. And it's like, is there multiple equipments, right? Because the Thermomix consists of multiple equipment. Actually, it is just this petite machine that you look, that you can see right in front of you here. So this is how it looks like. And the top, you will see very often in pictures, this is displayed in a lot of images online, okay? So what is this on the top that looks like a spaceship? It's what we call the Varoma. So when we explain the Varoma, you know, oh, this is what it is. What is the Varoma for? It is actually a steamer. Okay, so when you place it on top, you can use this now to put your food that you want to steam inside the room. Okay, now moving inside, you will see that there is a tray and there is this base that is called the dish and it comes with a cover. So it, you will also now realize that you can steam two layers of food together at one time. So one on the dish lower layer and one on the upper tray layer, which you will realize, which you are able to see later on when Ezrin does some steaming to show you how the Varoma works. Okay? In terms of size, it is 3.3 liter. So it's very roomy and you can even place a whole chicken inside here to steam. It's very comfortable. Right? So two layers, you see easy steaming. Right, moving this aside, we move down here. On the top here where we usually cover the lid, this is the lid, this is the measuring cup, okay? So the purpose of the measuring cup is to cover the hole that it avoids clutter. And the hole is there because then it gives you flexibility to add ingredients sometimes, you know? And there are multiple use of this the lid. And the top here measuring cup is also to ease simple liquid measurement. There are two measurements here, commonly used measurement 50 ml, and 100. When you receive the Thermomix, you'll be able to see this clearly, right? So there are two measuring marks here. So sometimes if you want to measure like milk or cream while it's cooking the soup, you could actually use measuring cup to put in the liquid and measure it and pour it straight into the hole while your ingredients at the bottom is cooking, okay? All right, so now we move down to the TM bowl. Now the greatest thing about TM bowl is that it's made of stainless steel. When you use stainless steel product, you realize that it doesn't absorb smell. So you can cook like rendang chicken here. The next moment, use the same bowl to make your sorbet, to make a smoothie. You can be rest assured that you won't have your rendang or chili smell crossing over to your desserts. Okay, so this is really, really practical. Having it in stainless steel. Inside, you will see there is a blade. right? And the blade has four sides. Every blade has all four sides, and there is the sharp side of the blade and the blunt side. So everyone has the sharp and the blunt, okay, on each side. So this is how the blade is going to move and stir your food. Okay? It's also made of high quality stainless steel, and you can also remove the blade to be washed and cleaned. Okay? And all this, the entire bowl, can go into your dishwasher as well, if you have a dishwasher. Right? The most important part of the machine, of course, it is the engine of the Thermomix. Now, when you talk about Thermomix motor, it is based on the technology called frictionless motor, meaning as it moves, there is no friction at all. Thereby, it doesn't create any heat. And you know, you can now realize that I can blend and blend and blend without stopping. I do not have the problem of having the motor smell that is created. There is no fan that is required in the Thermomix. And you could continuously cook and blend without having to stop and rest the Thermomix, right? And also because there is frictionless, you will also get very good quality smoothie. And also when you resort to like blending spices or blending your flour like almond meal, you know, you get very good quality because there's no heat that's created that is going to give it like a sticky kind of texture, all right? So it also helps to prevent oxidizing when you're blending your food. So the power of the Thermomix, it goes up to 10,700 RPM. That means the blade goes up 10,700 rotations per minute. Relating it to your car, you know, when you drive a car, most of you do drive, it is equivalent to 250 kilometers per hour of the speed. It's very powerful. And later you'll observe how that helps you in your daily cooking. Okay? All right, so this is the main screen. The greatest thing also is the TM6 comes with a big touch screen. Makes it easy for everyone to learn, regardless of whether you are a young child or an elderly, right? It makes it very attractive because we are also used to our smartphone. So this is just very similar to how your smartphone works. This is a home screen. Can you see three circles on the home screen? Yeah. So the first circle, which is enlarged as a time. Second circle, when I touch it, when it's enlarged, that represents the temperature. And the third represents the speed. Whenever you cook with Thermomix, there's only three things that you need to remember. How long you want to cook your food, then you set the time. What temperature you want to cook your food, that is the temperature. And then the third, it is the speed, the stirring speed and the blending speed. So it's only three things, time, temperature, speed, right? Very simple. Now, when I slide the screen, it's like, wow, what are these? These are all the multiple options, the functions that come with the Thermomix now. When I scroll it again, there's another screen that is populated with extra functions. And it's going to be added on as and when you use it because the TM6 is Wi-Fi, has a Wi-Fi built-in capability. Whenever you turn it on, it's going to scan for the latest version of software. And if there is any version that is being released by Forex, it will then automatically be updated. And sometimes certain version, new versions will also have added function. When it's updated, you can automatically see, oh, there is additional functions that's added to your machine. And it's at no additional cost, right? So I've been using it for about a year plus, and I think I've already had like five new functions that was added from then till now. Okay. Now, since it has Wi-Fi, when I scroll to the other side, you can see a wonderful color screen. Now, this brings you to online. Accessing to the Cookie2 platform, the 60,000 recipes. So you can search, you can, you know, look for the recipes that you want, and it gives you guided cooking. Okay, so roughly, this is how the Thermomix is like, right? So to all the Thermomix, for some of you who has already purchased it, for some of you who have not, we have three options for everyone. First is the full payment. The price is at 718. We do have a 200 ringgit voucher that is still running now. So bringing the price to 6988 only, so do get your hands on it before the voucher is, the promo is stopped. And then we also have financing option up to 24 months works out to ringgit a day. Right, wonderful, right? ringgit a day for the entire family to eat well and for you to be able to cook at home. And we have the third option. If you already have a Thermomix and you feel that, hey, what Pingping is doing today, what Olivia, what Ezrin and Sunita is doing is really fun. You know, you can join us as a working partner and you can earn your demo unit free. If you feel that one unit is good and you want a second unit, look into the working partner program. Do not need to buy a second unit. Come and, you know, have fun with us and at the same time earn your second unit. Okay? If you're keen, do contact your advisor. I'm sure they will be able to share the details with you on a separate session. So what is a Thermomix? It is exactly like our smartphone. It is your smart kitchen now. Okay? So you want a blend, you do not need to take out a blender anymore, like before, right? Very cumbersome. You keep the blender and you take out, you keep the blender and take out. After a while, you don't really use it anymore, especially like cake mixer and everything, right? When you need multiple things, you find it a lot of work, a lot of after cooking process, the cleaning part, right? So it is your blender. If you want to steam, you know, like, hey, yeah, I can steam this at the moment. It's also my steamer. I want to emulsify. I want to whip my mayonnaise. Is also my emulsifier. Okay, if I want to make some soups and or some cream and I need long hours of stirring, it is also my pot and it's also my stirrer. If I want to grind my spices, it is also my grinding machine, right? So it is all in one. If I want sous vide, it's also my sous vide machine. If I want to slow cook, it is also my slow cook. So it brings back to the idea that I don't need multiple things. If I do have all those, I did have most of it. Can you imagine putting them on the kitchen top? You won't do that, right? Because it would be very messy. Now with Thermomix, it's this is all you need on the kitchen top, okay? And the best thing is it is a smart kitchen, meaning you'll never ever get to save it. You'll be using it multiple times every single day. If I want to weigh something, I'll go to my Thermomix. Morning, I make my hard-boiled eggs. It is my pot, okay? I want to make my smoothie, it becomes my smoothie maker, right? So it is something that you never ever get to keep. The perfect kitchen for everyone. Cooking for a single person, you can also proportion the amount that you want to cook for one person portion. So it's the best thing that for people who are cooking for just one person. You don't need to buy multiple things. One does it all, simplify, and also you have a very clean and tidy kitchen. For people who are starting new family, really, it's the best. You don't need to look at other things. Start with the Thermomix when the family expands. When you have baby, it's the best baby food processor. When children grows up, you want a variety. You want cakes, cookies, ice cream, smoothies. It is all there. Prepared to expand and grow with the family. And your family can cook together. But it's so safe that even children can cook along with you. For those who are in their golden years, it is great because you would want to have a good quality lifestyle, still be able to eat well. And, you know, when you cook, you don't need to be standing for long hours in the kitchen. It can be quite tiring. With the Thermomix, you can also enjoy your cooking and also continue to have a healthy diet at home, right? Okay, we're going to start with something that is very refreshing. And we have multiple partners here today sharing their recipes. And for the first recipe, I'd like to pass you to Sunita. Sunita is going to share with you a wonderful morning refreshing drink. Okay? So I'll pass the screen to Sunita. Let's welcome Sunita.
Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me loud and clear?
Yes. Yes, we can.
Okay. So today, you see, I'm seated and I'm going to be using my Thermomix. The reason is I actually injured my ankle last week, so I'm still not so steady on my feet. But, you know, with the Thermomix, anything is possible, so you can actually just sit down and do your cooking as well. Right? I'm going to show you a really fast and easy orange juice today. And we're going to follow the recipe from Cookie Doo. So Cookie Doo is our Thermomix recipe platform, and we currently have over 67,000 recipes available on Cookie Doo. So what I'm going to do is I have already added it to my calendar. I just have to press on these three lines on the side and I look at my week. And I can see orange juice here. So I just touch on the recipe and I say, start cooking, all right? So it says, okay, 100 grams of ice cubes, next. 3 to 4 navel oranges, next. 10 to 20 grams of caster sugar. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to show you how we use the turbo function in our Thermomix as well. So I'm just going to press home, swipe my screen, and just go add in the 20 grams of sugar into my bowl. All right, put the lid on and just touch turbo. The minute you touch turbo, the lid will automatically lock into place. This is a safety feature because our turbo function, we actually have three settings, a 0.5 second, 1 second, and 2 seconds, all right? So with a 0.5 second, you can do precision chopping or blending, especially if you want to chop your nuts to make like your satay sauce or any sauce that you want to blend something, but not too fine. So I'm actually just going to use 2 seconds to blend my caster sugar into almost icing sugar so that it will be easier to blend in with the drink as well. So just give it a turn. Just for 2 seconds and it's done. So then we unlock. And if you can see, the caster sugar is almost icing sugar now. All right. So we're going to put in 100 grams of ice cubes. So the weighing scale comes up when you're using recipes from Cookie Doo. So it will automatically show you, and I'm going to just press tear to get it back to zero and just put in 100 grams of ice. And then next, so we have, I actually have 3 navel oranges. So you just quarter them and remove the skin and the seeds. So we're going to put that in as well. Okay, and then we go next. So we've already added the sugar. And next is insert the measuring cup, which means to put the lid on. And next, just 20 seconds at speed 9. So all you have to do now is, if you look on your screen, you'll actually see it's highlighted up to the 9. So I'm just going to turn it all the way to 9. So that's 20 seconds. And if you can see, the orange juice is almost done. You just go next. and add in 300 to 400 grams of water. So I'm using 400 grams of ice water. Next, insert the lid again. And now it's just gonna mix it for 1 minute at speed 8. All right, it's done. So to stop the sound, you can actually just touch the screen or press the button, right? And then we go next, and it says serve immediately. Okay. So if you look at it, it's a gorgeous juice, okay, which I'm now going to pour out. So this is one full jug with just 3 oranges. And if we pour it out into a glass, I will let you know how it tastes. So you can make your own fresh juices at home every single day in just 1 minute and 20 seconds. Imagine how much you would pay for a glass of fresh juice outside. So cheers, everyone. This is so refreshing, all right? So what else can you do with the turbo mode? You can actually grind your own coffee beans. For those of you who like buying specialty coffee from Starbucks, etc., you can grind your own coffee beans. For those who make macarons or are gluten intolerant and you want to make your almond flour, you can use your Thermomix to grind your own almonds. Or you can also make your fresh lemonade at home and your own so many, I mean, the possibilities are endless, all right? So I'm going to hand it over to the next presenter, who is Olivia, and we'll see you later.
Hello, good morning, everyone. I'm Olivia. Thank you so much, Sunita, for sharing such a refreshing drink for our breakfast today. And the next recipe I'll be sharing with you is called the lemon drizzle cake, okay? And this is one of the most delicious cakes I've ever tried, okay? And I've baked it so many times, okay? So those of you who just got your Thermomix, you have to try this recipe. It's on Cookidoo. It's called lemon drizzle cake, right? So first, I've already prepared the ingredients. So I have here self-raising flour. I have unsalted butter. The brand of butter I'm using is Kerrygold, okay, and it's softened, cut into cubes, and I'm using free-range eggs, and here is raw cane sugar, and I've reduced the sugar. So the benefit of cooking with Thermomix is that you can actually, use organic flour. So I'm using organic flour. I always bake with organic flour. And also sugar, I use a healthier option, which is the raw cane sugar. You can also use other types of sugar if you like. And then I have some fresh milk. I have some lemon zest here. And you also need to prepare a baking tin, okay, and line it with the baking paper, okay? So here we're gonna start. So very easy. Cookie Do is a recipe platform and it's guided cooking step by step. So if you have never baked before in your life, you will definitely have fail-proof recipes, okay? So because all the recipes on Cookie Do is tried and tested, right? So there's no room for error, right? So all you need to do is prepare the ingredients, and on the right here, you will see the instructions. So you can view Cookie Do from the TM6 screen on your phone, or you can also use your notebook or iPad as well. So any device, you can actually view Cookie Do, right? So next is tap on start cooking. So here you have to preheat your oven at 170 degrees, right? And then next is to line the baking tin. And here is two lemons thinly peeled. Okay, so I've already done that, right? Okay, so I'm going to place in the lemon here. Also the sugar. So very simple. It has a built-in weighing scale, which I really love, okay? Especially for those of you who love to bake. The weighing scale here actually weighs in 1 gram increment. So it's very precise. So for example, you want to weigh ingredients like 3 grams, you will get very accurate results, okay? So here we need 50 grams of sugar. So you can actually pour in directly to weigh, or another way of weighing is actually what you do is you place an empty bowl right on top here, go to the weighing scale, tear it so that it zero rises, and then only you pour in the ingredients to weigh so that you will not make a mistake, because especially in baking, you need to have very accurate measurements of your ingredients, right? So then only you pour in directly. So I've already pre-weighed my ingredients, so I'm just going to just pour in directly. Okay, 50 grams of sugar. Right. And then next is insert measuring cup and all. So I'm going to insert the measuring cup. Next, okay. So the time has been preset for us. There's no temperature required because we're not cooking. All right. And next is to turn speed selector to speed 10. So here is the speed selector. I just have to turn it all the way to speed 10. Okay, so when you hear this beautiful music, it's ready, okay? So you just tap on it. Okay, it's done. So it has actually helped me to mill the sugar and the lemon, okay, to very, very fine. So if you like to have a body scrub, you can actually make your own body scrub with Thermomix, all right? So some people like to do with sugar because sugar is actually very good for the skin. You know, some people are sensitive to salt. So you can actually make your own lemon scrub at home, okay? So here it is. So you can have lemon, you can add some essential oils and make your own scrub at home. Okay, so we're done. Okay, it says scrape down. So even scraping down the bowl, it will tell me what to do with the tuna. Insert the measuring cup and then, okay. And then next, I'm going to repeat again because it wants it to be finer, all right? So for another 10 seconds. Right. So now after the 10 seconds, it's even finer, right? Okay. So what can you imagine at home in your kitchen? What can you mill very, very fine? You can do like white pepper. You can make your own chicken stock powder. You can mill your own spices, herbs for cooking. And I also mill a lot of seasoning, actually seasoning powder. So I actually make my own mushroom stock powder. You know, if you want some Japanese umami flavor, you can actually make your own kombu powder in here. So a lot of things you can actually mill fine to like powder. Okay? Even you can actually make your own almond flour as well, because almond flour is actually very costly. So you can actually mill your own almond to make almond flour. Okay. Next is scrape down, and then add in the sugar. So I'm using the raw cane sugar here. Okay. Next, add in the unsalted butter. Next, add 3 large eggs. So I'm actually following every single step here, right? Next, insert the measuring plate in the bowl. Okay, so now it's going to blend for 20 seconds at speed number 5. If you have any questions, please feel free to type in the chat, right? And we'll try our very best to answer them. Okay. Next is to add in the self-raising flour. Okay. So I'll just show you in a bit after I've added the flour, and I'll show you the result. And if you would like to sieve the flour, you can actually do it. The thermomix, you don't have to do it manually, so you just use 1 to 2 seconds on turbo mode. It will actually help you to sift the flour, okay? And then you add in 20 grams of milk, right? Okay, and it will mix for 15 seconds. Okay, voila, it's done. Okay, all right. So now we scrape down the spatula. Next. All right. Then it will mix again for another 15 seconds. Okay. Next step is to transfer the batter into the tin here. Okay, so before I do that, I'm going to show it to you. So our smooth batter is ready. It was really fast, isn't it? It was just a few minutes and smooth batter is achieved, all right? So we see baking now is such an easy task, right? So I'm just gonna transfer the batter here. So if you have a party or if you have friends over, you can make this lemon drizzle cake. It's always a hit, and you know, I really like the zesty flavor of lemon. Okay, and because after the cake has been baked, the last step is to actually have the lemon and sugar mixed together, and then you actually drizzle it over the cake. So it's really, really lovely, okay? I tell you enough how much I love this cake. So if you have a bit more of the batter inside the mixing bowl, you just have to place it inside here. just give it a spin. So I'll go on, okay, let me just go right. So I'll probably put it on maybe speed 6 for a while and let all the batter come out from the plate, okay? So nothing goes to waste. And after baking, you can also use the pre-clean mode to clean the batter, all right? And it will be really, really clean. So what you do is you place in 1 liter. There's a 1 liter mark inside the mixing bowl. So you place water inside and a few squirts of detergent and go to the pre-clean mode, all right? So I'm just going to show you where's the pre-clean mode. You swipe to your left and you look for the pre-clean mode. So we have 4 to 5 different cleaning modes, from dough mode until cleaning things like really oily food and all. So you can actually use the pre-clean mode and it is very, very clean. Okay. So now, next what I will do now is bake this for 40 to 50 minutes, depending on your oven, at 180 degrees. Okay. So what I do is you need to tap, all right? So you can tap to remove any bubbles. Do this, okay? All right. Then you bake it, okay? So when the skewer comes out clean, so you can use a skewer. So when the skewer comes out clean, means that it is ready and yeah, so after the last step, you would actually drizzle the lemon sauce over it, okay? So you have a perfect meat every time. You can make your breads, you can make your pasta, you can make your pizza dough in just 2-3 minutes using our dough mode. You can even make a meatball, fishball in just 2-3 minutes, okay? It's always fast and fresh because we're using the best quality ingredients when we are actually baking or, you know, making our own food at home, okay? So now I'm going to pass on to Ping Ping, who will be sharing with us the next recipe. Thank you. See you later.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Hope you can hear me. My name is Ezri, and today I'll be making a 3-in-1 dish. Okay, so this recipe is a cookie dough recipe. So what's good about cookie dough is you can actually plan your whole week or your whole month on what you want to cook. Okay, so for this dish, I already planned it to cook for today. So you can go to the menu up here and go to my week.
No, it wasn't.
And you can see once you have to have Wi-Fi to access this. Okay, so it says here salmon and basmati rice with dill cream sauce. Okay, so just press on it. So with every cookie dough recipe, if you scroll down, you can see all the ingredients and the preparation, and you can access the same information from your phone, your iPad, or your desktop. Okay, you just have to log in with the same account details, right? And then if you care about calories, okay, if you count your calories, you can also see the energy, the protein, carb, and fats for each of the recipe in cookie dough. Okay, and every recipe, they also have tips. Okay, so here it says here, whipping, use whipping cream with 35% fat, okay, for this recipe. Okay, so make sure you scroll down and read everything. Okay, like someone just now asked whether they tell us the baking pan size, everything will be informed in the cookie dough recipe, okay? So don't worry. Okay, so just press start cooking. Okay, and here, straight away, it tells that it needs 1,000 grams of water. Okay, so if the weight changes, okay, just press the tab button, okay, and then you can pour your water. And then all you have to do is just press next. 20 grams of olive oil. So you can see the weighing scale changes in 1 gram increment. So it's very precise, especially if you're baking. 1 gram is very important, okay? Because sometimes you need like 5 grams of yeast or 6 grams of yeast. Okay. And then, so next, 1 teaspoon of fine sea salt. I'm using Himalayan salt. It's okay. So just pour everything in. Then insert simmering basket. Okay. So this is the simmering basket for your Thermomix. All right. So just insert. And it says here to weigh the basmati rice. So I've actually weighed it. All right. It's already in here. So I'm just going to put inside 250 grams. And then next, it says insert varoma tray in varoma dish. So this is called the varoma, okay? So what it's saying is to put the tray, okay? This is a varoma tray. Okay? And then it says to grease varoma tray. I've already greased it with olive oil. And to place 4 fresh salmon fillet. Okay, this is 2 salmon fillet because they asked for 125 grams each. So this is around 250 grams each. So it works out the same, okay? But if let's say your family is small, you only want to steam 1 salmon fillet, it's okay, just put 1, okay? And then season with salt and pepper. And then place covered varoma into position. Okay, so now you want to put the varoma on top. But since we are not using, the recipe doesn't tell you to put anything in the dish, but I have put some broccoli. Okay, can you see? Yeah. Okay, because if not, it's just empty here. So I just put some broccoli. Okay, and then, yeah. To use the varoma, you need to make sure you cover with the lid first. Okay. Then put the varoma on top like this. And then now, cover. And now it has set 15 minutes. And then the temperature is varoma, and the speed you need to turn it to speed 4. Okay, so I'm gonna extend. Actually, the recipe says 15 to 17 minutes, so I'm just gonna extend to 16 minutes, okay? Just 1 extra minute, and turn to speed 4. Okay, so now it's cooking, it's steaming the rice, my veggie, and also my salmon fillet on top. Okay, so steaming is actually a very good way of because when you steam your food, you preserve the nutrients and also the vitamins. And this 3-in-1 recipe is so easy, right? Just put it here, and then later I will be doing the sauce. Okay, so if you want to see what's coming next, you can actually see these 3 small buttons on top. You press the 3 buttons, you can choose the recipe detail, and you can scroll down and see what is the next step. So once this is done, I will put it aside, and then I'm going to add in onion and garlic to chop, okay? And then I'm going to put in butter and saute it together with the onion and garlic. And then I will add some cream, veggie stock, tomato puree, dill, and then confa, okay? Just to thicken the dill sauce, and then it's done. So after 17 minutes, this 3 will be done, and then I'm just going to put the sauce for around 5-6 minutes later on, and just pour on top. Then what else you can do while you are cooking, you can actually weigh ingredients on top. Okay, but the speed has to be 4 and below. And the weighing scale will go by 5 gram increment. Okay, it's not in 1 gram because it's continuous in the right solution to be moving a bit. So if you want to do 4-in-1, you can also do 4-in-1 recipes. Okay, so you can have your soup at the bottom. Can have your rice, your potatoes, or pasta, or veggies in the simmering basket, and you can put your veggie on top here and your meat on top. Okay, so you can have 4-in-1 within 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Okay, if you do this manually, you might have to use a few pots. You have your rice cooker, you have your steamer, right? So here you just need 1 bowl and our varoma, and it's ready. Okay, so if you're a busy person, even if you're not busy, but if you have an option, right, why not, right? Just put everything, or before you go to work, you defrost your meat in the fridge, you come back to work, you just put everything here, and you can go and shower and bathe, take care of your kids, and then your meal will be ready in just 20 minutes, okay? So that is our 4-in-1. So make sure you try our late cooking when you get the Thermomix, okay? So I'm just gonna go through a few modes, okay? So we have, one of the modes is called the kettle mode. Okay, so kettle mode is a bit different from our traditional kettle because your traditional kettle, when you turn it on, it goes straight to 100 degrees. Okay, Okay, so our kettle is very special. You can actually set the temperature that you want. So if you want to heat up your formula baby milk, you can do it at 37 degrees. Black green tea or tea, you should enjoy it at 75 degrees. And coffee is the best at 95 degrees. Okay, because when you make your tea and coffee at 100 degrees, it's too hot actually. So you are burning the flavor away. So if you want to enjoy tea and coffee, have it try it at this different temperature. Okay. And you also have the slow cook mode. Up to 8 hours on reverse. Okay, so you can just put your meat in and you can just leave it here. Okay, some recipes will take 1 hour, 2 hours, but it can go up to 8 hours depending on which recipe you're trying. Okay, so it's very succulent, it's very nice and tender. Okay, so you must try our slow cook mode. So this is very interesting. You can also ferment. Okay, we have a fermentation mode. You can make your own yogurt. All right, or even cheese. If you're very adventurous, you can even try making your own cheese. Okay, it takes 12 hours, so it's best to start at night. And then when you wake up in the morning, it's ready for you. Okay. So we have a lot of yogurt and cheese recipes in the explore. Okay, so this is my favorite mode. Okay, it's called the sous vide function. Okay, so sous vide is when you get restaurant quality food at home. Okay, so all you need is a BPA-free bag. Okay, a good brand is Glad, G-L-A-D. You can get it at most supermarkets. Okay, so you can put your meat in, put some seasoning, put some herbs, and then just place it into the bowl. And it will cook on low temperature, but a long period, okay, maybe 1 hour to 1.5, depending on the meat. Okay, so when you cook this way, you get to preserve the nutrients, the flavor. Okay, it's very, very nice. You have to try it. Try the steak, okay? So you can actually in restaurants they have sous vide machines at the back. So when you go to the restaurant and order your steak, they will ask for the doneness, right? So let's say if you say medium, they will take out from the sous vide machine and then they will sear it to the doneness that you want. So the same thing, because the recipe in here that's is actually for rare steak. I'm not sure whether that's medium or not. So rare steak, and then you take it out and you just sear about 1 minute each side. And then it's very nice. Okay, you can also make it with a Bernese sauce. Okay, so make sure you try the sous vide function, okay, when you get your thermomix. Okay, so now I will pass on to Bing Bing. She is going to show us a meat dish, okay, using high temperature mode. See you later.
Yay, I'm back. Recently I was exploring the cookie dough and then I found, well, there is a interesting recipe, which is the oyster sauce beef. You know, I often tried to cook beef last time before with my pots and pans and always turn out very hardy and chewy, right? So when you eat out in the Chinese restaurant or, you know, those high-end restaurants, you realize that how did the beef get so tender? It's because they go through this high heat cooking first and then they saute in all the other things at the end. But that needs a little bit of skill. So I found this recipe in Cookie Do that does exactly these steps for you. And I felt that it's wonderful and I tried it out. It's really, really tasty and it's very tender. So how do I look out for the recipe? What I did was I already went into the Cookie Do, found the recipe, saved it in my collection. So I want to show you how I have saved it. Once I save it in my collection, that's my own created collection. That means I can now put it into my recipes. And here you will see there's created collection. Let me bring it closer. And there's the created collection and the saved collection, all right? So I have put into my created collection. Over here, you will see that I have multiple albums that have been created. So I have my baking savory, my beverage, my high temp album, and then I've created the main dishes for my main beef chicken. It makes it easy for me to search for the recipe that I want. Once I put it into my saved collection, it is already there. And even though there's no Wi-Fi connection, I can still look up for the recipe because it's saved inside the TM6. The other thing about TM6, it comes with its own memory that you can save up to 10,000 recipes inside, all right? So So here I have my beef recipe, which I'm going to go in. And here it is. And now I'm getting started now. All right. So when I scroll up, like what Olivia has shown you, these are the list of recipes. So this is in Chinese. For me, I do not know. I do not read Chinese very well. So what I did was I did a Google Translate. And then I'm able to cook as well. Okay, so let me go through the steps with you now. Okay. So the ingredients I've prepared here, all right? Okay. And when I click on start cooking, it tells me step by step on what to do. Now, because this is high temperature, this instruction, when you Google, it will say that, oh, make sure your bowl is clean and that you have prepared your ingredients according to the recipe list, okay? And then we go next. And first thing it says to weigh, to make sure that you have 250 grams of sliced beef tenderloin. So how do you ensure before cooking? Like what Olivia has shown you, you would put the container on top. And then, zero it. So now what I'm weighing is actually just the beef. Okay, so you put in the beef here, for example, which I did it earlier. All right. And then the next thing it says to add in the seasoning. So the seasoning, if I can explain it to you and convert the ingredients for you, it will be 1 tablespoon of oyster sauce, 1 teaspoon of soya sauce, 1 teaspoon of dark soya sauce, 1 teaspoon of sugar, and 1 teaspoon of corn flour, all right? So let's go next. First thing it says to place 40 grams of oil into the TM bowl. Very interesting, right? No other ingredients, place oil first, okay? So we're gonna pour in some oil. Zero back. Okay. You notice that I'm using extra virgin olive oil. You know, I can safely use any best oil I have without having to worry about oil getting overburnt because there's temperature control in the thermomix. So the high temp for me, it will only go up to 160. All right, thereby it doesn't burn my oil. So I'm gonna put in about 40 grams. But even in this cooking, right, I can still enjoy good quality oil in my food. All right, there you go, I have 40 grams. Next, it says to cover. So cover the lid. All right, if you're beginners of thermomix, remember when you place the lid, it's good to give it a twist, all right? And it helps to protect your lid that you can actually prolong the lifespan of the lid and place the MC cup. Next, it has set the time to 2 minutes because it's cookie dough and the temperature has been set to baroma. And it says turn speed is full. So what is exactly happening now? It's happening now. It's heating up the oil. Because later on, you're going to saute the beef on high temp, right? So this is the moment, like how you would do it. If you had done this on the pan or your pot, on a wok, you would put in the oil and you would start to heat up, right? Heat up the oil before you put in your meat, okay? To go on a high heat, blanching through oil. Okay, and when you used to do, I used to do this on a long time ago, it's actually quite scary, right? Because you will always anticipate what's coming next, and that's the scariest part. When you put in the next ingredients, most of the time you get oil splattering, and sometimes you even get them splatter on your hands. Okay, so now as it's heating up, it will show you as well the thermomix, the temperature you wanted is baroma. And the design, the temperature within the thermomix as well is also being shown on a smaller size here, the alphabet here. So it was at zero and then it goes up to 37 and now it is also at aroma, which means it has heated up thoroughly. Okay. And you have done this on the wok. Would you even dare to walk away? No, right? But at this time, if you have a thermomix, and you do this part with the thermomix, you can safely, you know, go on to prepare your next ingredients and attend to other household needs while this is being done for you. Okay, so it's just another short 25 seconds. You don't even need to keep an eye on it. Because when it's done, it will sound and it tells you that, hey, I'm ready for the next step. And look, I'm wearing white t-shirt, yeah? Plain white t-shirt, and I'm cooking something like that, which is something was something really impossible before. Don't even need an apron. I don't even need to have my, my hair. I don't even need to tie it up and bun up, you know, to ensure that there's no smell. So it's done. Can you hear the sound? All right. So it's done. Come back to your thermomix and click next. Now it says that you need to add the marinated beef with all the ingredients I've shared just now inside. Okay. I'm going to pour the beef inside. Okay. I can be so safe inside it without having to worry. It's actually, the oil is very hot now. Click on next and it says to put on the lid. And because we are going on high temp, we need the splash guard, which comes together with your TM60. Okay? Right? It's done. Now it has turned on the temperature to high temp and it has set the cooking time to 4 minutes. So I just need to turn the dial and it's now starting to cook at high temperature. So this is the blanching of the beef in super hot oil. And can you imagine doing this on the wok? What would have happened? Right? You would have been trying to move as far as possible and reach up your hand and stretch up as much as possible that you can still reach the wok and the hot oil and the beef and start to stir them and, you know, and saute them, right? But now it's all done inside. And you can hear the sizzling sound, okay? So because the phone that I'm using is quite far away, if I can bring the phone closer, you can hear the sound, right? Sunita, Esrin, I would like you to let me know if you can hear the sound when I bring the phone closer. Right? Can you hear the sound?
Yes.
Yeah, can you imagine if we had done it on the walk? You would have been
the sizzling sound.
Yeah. And this is high temp cooking with the TM6. As simple as that, the greatest thing is that there is no oil splatter. I can be standing safely right beside it and still cook high temperature cooking. Okay. The splash guard is a very unique accessory because it has holes on top. So, you know, when you do high temp cooking, you would very often want the water to evaporate and keeping the content somewhat a little bit drier, right? So you wouldn't cover your wok, right? Same thing, it's not covered. So the splash guard has holes that it allows vapor to evaporate and also air to go through and giving you the same result as how you would have done it on the wok. Okay? So apart from high temp cooking, which is an option in TM6, of course it does come with something called low temperature cooking as well, which I've used it every day. Low temperature cooking are great for, like, you know, regular sauteing of vegetable, or you tumis your sambal, you know, for like 10, 15 minutes and you don't want burn at the bottom, right? Those are great for that, that kind of recipes too, right? So you can now imagine now with the Thermomix, you can be so flexible. You can go for your daily saute of your vegetable, your meat at low temp. You can still enjoy that kind of cuisine. You can also opt for high temperature, right? Like what we're doing here. If you are here with me, you'll be able to smell the wonderful flavors that's coming out from the aroma that's coming out from the saute here itself. So there's just another minute more. So we will wait for a little while. While it's cooking, right? The other things that I've done with high temp are like pork as well. If you like to brown meat, it's also great to do with high temp. High temp also allows you to do caramelizing, which goes up to 170 degrees. So if you enjoy nut brittle, for example, making caramel, it's really a hassle to do it on pot And then after that, the worst part is the after cooking process that you need to clean the caramel. Yeah. So with the Thermomix, you can do it easily. And after that, to clean, just simply pop in some water, turn on the pre-clean mode, select that you want the pre-clean caramel, and then it will do it for you by itself. And after that, just discard the liquid. If there's some on the side, just use a sponge to just rinse it off, and you have your clean TN bowl back again. So it's as easy as that, right? So you can do things like that, right? Okay, so it's done, right? So I have, oops, and I'm sure you are curious to see how it turns out inside. And I can show you with my camera here. You can see the sizzle, right? And it happens all within the pot, within the TN bowl. Okay, that's the beef is ready. Nicely done, just al dente done, that is not overcooked. We move on to the next step. And it says here to put in 100 grams of bell pepper. It says green bell pepper, but I ran out. This is all I have. I had about 60 grams. So I added some red bell pepper as well. And also some, we call that 40 grams of the onions, right? So you want to go for the yellow onion, cut it into this size, right? It's about 1 inch in size, right? And then we're going to pop everything in. Okay, next. You see the MC cup and the lid? So instruction simply means that you will need to cover the TN bowl. Next, set the time to 2 minutes for aroma, and it says turn speed to spoon. So all I need to do is to turn the dial to spoon. So the whole process for this wonderful dish, delicious dish, is just 4 minutes for the beef on high temperature, which gives it a very tender result. And then another 2 minutes of sauteing at low temp, all right? Even though it's aroma, this is considered low temp because I've added in vegetable. So the cookie dough is very, the recipe is very clever. I want high temp for my beef, but I want low temp for my vegetable because I want to keep the nutrients of my vegetable. I want my vegetable to look vibrant when it's cooked. So that's why it has now, you know, put in the low temp to cook my vegetable. And later we will see how the bell peppers turn out. Okay, so for this dish, for some people, you can also add some cut of other vegetables as well. For example, like broccoli, right? But for broccoli, maybe you want to extend another minute more because broccoli is a bit hardier. And then you can also have a different kind of combination. Basically, you can play around with it. Okay. So the thing about low temp is it ensures that it doesn't overcook your food. It doesn't fume your oil. It doesn't burn your oil, that it becomes carcinogenic. And there is no oil fume in the kitchen. All right, so you continue to eat like that, especially if you invest in a lot of organic vegetable. You want the vegetable to cook the right way, or else your investment in organic vegetable is going to be all wasted, right? So the reason why we buy organic vegetable is because it has higher content of nutrients and vitamins. But if the process is being handled right in cooking, you'll also be able to reap the full benefits of the nutrients of the vegetable, you know, at the end of cooking. And it's wonderful because you're actually serving your whole family with super nutritious food every single day. And now my dish is done. I'm going to show you how it looks like. Okay. This is how. All right, let me bring it close so you can see it. The results immediately. Wow. All right, I'm going to plate it out now while I pass the screen to Olivia. She's going to share with you how do you start with your Thermomix? How do you bring the Thermomix home? You know, listen to all the details because at the moment as well, there is the current pandemic. The machine has been selling very well. And we have very limited stock left, especially for the English version. Okay, so if you feel that this wonderful machine is going to be of great help to you at home for your daily cooking, right? please do get your hands on the thermometer soon. I will pass to Olivia now. She's going to explain how do you purchase your machine, your thermometer, and get it as soon as possible. All right, so I'll pass the screen.
Hey, hi everyone. So thank you so much for watching our cooking show. And so you've seen all the benefits here today, right? The benefits of cooking with Thermomix. It is healthy. You know, everyone can cook. And do you like that, you know, it's actually quick and easy. You saw how our chefs have presented, you know, 4 to 5 dishes today, and it was effortless and it was easy. And did you like that, you know, the auto cooking function, you do not need to even use your hand to stir while it's cooking. And after cooking, it also cleans for you, okay? And I wanted to show you that I used the pre-clean mode earlier to wash the batter and see how clean it is. So all you need to do is, after you use the pre-clean mode, you just need to wash the PM bowl, run it under water, and then that's it, okay? So it is so easy for you to clean, all right? Okay, and then it saves space. Imagine 20 appliances all in one kitchen, okay? 20 appliances here. If today I were to have 20 appliances right on the tabletop, it will actually take up a lot of space, okay? But now Thermomix, it's all in one here. You use it for your breakfast, you use it for your lunch, use it for your dinner, and you can also make your afternoon tea time treats right here, okay? So it's time saving, and you save a lot of space as well, okay? And goodbye to cooking fumes, right? We do not need to be toiling in the hot kitchen. And you see, our chefs are cooking actually in their dry kitchen, not even in the wet kitchen, okay? And you don't even need a kitchen hood here. So this is actually my daily cooking space, all right? I don't actually go to my wet kitchen to cook, all right? As you can see here, there's no cooking hood, all right? So this is the most exciting part now, okay? Own your Thermomix at $6,988. For a full payment, you will get an extra gift, which is a cookbook of your choice. So we have Malay Kitchen, we have Tasty Asia, we have Easy Meals cookbook for you to choose, right? And we also have financing options for up to 24 months. So for 24 months per month, you're paying about 290 over ringgit, which is around 10 ringgit per day, right? So it's around paying for a gym membership, right? Most of the time we pay 200 over ringgit for a gym membership, but we do not even go to the gym, okay? So that's why 10 ringgit per day is so affordable for your whole family to enjoy 3 to 4 meals a day, right? And the complete package comes with all the accessories you see we used here today, okay? And it also includes a basic cookbook. So this basic cookbook, you can choose in English or Chinese, and there are more than 160 recipes in here. Very comprehensive cookbook. It is one of my favorite cookbooks because, you know, you get from starters, okay, just let me show it to you. So you get from starters to desserts, everything all in here. And just have a look at this ice cream, okay? I know kids love it, the adults love it. We all love ice cream, okay? So you can make your own homemade ice cream. You can, you know, make your own, your own pies, okay? You can do breads. We have a lot of recipes on breads. Okay, see how lovely this milk bread is. So when you get your Thermomix, make sure you make your own homemade breads, okay? So this cookbook is a must-have. And also the soft copy of the cookbook in English and Chinese is also in Cookidoo. Okay, so you choose the hard copy, but the soft copy is in Cookidoo. So it depends on the hard copy which you want to refer to, right? And we have regular cooking classes as well. So normally we do have cooking classes at our studio at the HQ. And we deliver nationwide for free, okay, right at your doorstep. And we also have an online recipe community. If you are, if you have a recipe or if you have a special recipe which you want to share with the users, you can actually upload it on our recipe community. Okay. And we have a free unboxing service as well. So we have unboxing, which we can send you a video step by step on how it's done. Your advisor can also do a video call with you to do the unboxing, or we can also do a face-to-face unboxing session, right? And of course, your advisor who has invited you here today for a cooking show will be giving you a lot of support. Okay, she'll be sharing a lot of recipes with you, updates on our regular classes, and share a lot of tips and tricks with you on how to fully utilize your Thermomix, okay? And there's 2-year warranty against manufacturing defects for home use. For commercial use, it is 1-year warranty, okay? So if you're interested to be like us, okay, you can join us as a Thermomix advisor. So you can work flexible hours. You can, you know, learn new cooking skills, because we have, every week we have advisor gathering, and we also share recipes as well on every Monday. So if you like what you see here today, you can also join and be a part of our family, okay? And okay, so you know, today you have joined such a wonderful session with us here today. I'm sure you have a lot of friends who you can share such a wonderful tool with, okay? So friends, you know, who are always looking at cookbooks, they still can't cook, because why? When they flip, you know, Jamie Oliver's recipe, for example, and it says medium fire, high fire, okay? So they have no idea, no clue what is that, okay? And even they have a whole library full of cookbooks, they still are not able to bake their own bread and cakes, okay? So I know in your mind, you have friends who you can share the Thermomix with, okay? And friends who are health conscious, you know, they do yoga, maybe perhaps they're on certain diets, you know, keto diets, very popular now. Maybe they are gluten intolerant. So we have a lot of gluten-free recipes in Cookidoo as well. So you can also share with your friends. Okay? Friends who are always busy eating out, you know, they have no time to cook at all. They always pack food. They always order grab food. So you can tell your friends about it, because when you eat out all the time, you know, the ingredients, they will not use good quality cooking oils, you know, things like that. But when you cook at home, you can use the best quality ingredients, okay? And friends who have children, very important, you know, when kids are, you know, are growing, building their immune system, building their health is so important. So tell your friends about the Thermomix so that the kids can also be cooking together with them, all right? Okay, so a big thank you to you who joined us today. And also, when you opt for an installment plan or a full-time payment, we also have a wonderful gift for you here today, which is called the Thermal Server. So the TM Bowl is a 2.2 liter capacity. The Thermal Server is also a 2.2 liter capacity, okay? So what is the Thermal Server? The Thermal Server is actually an insulated stainless steel container. Okay, so after cooking, for example, you cook curry chicken, you cook your mee hoon and all, you can actually place it in here and you actually keep warm for a few hours. Okay, so it's also for cold purpose as well. After you've made your ice cream with Thermomix, you can actually place it in here and keep it in the freezer. Okay, and it also comes with a base. So when the content inside here is hot, you can actually use the base here, okay, to actually place it on your dining table. And what I really like, that it also has a lid as well, okay? So how can you redeem this wonderful gift, okay? So all you need to do is, after you have purchased within 30 days, host a cooking demonstration. So it can be at your home, it can be in our HQ, because we have regular cooking sessions at our HQ on every Wednesday and Saturday. So you can also invite your friends over to the HQ, or you can invite your friends to join our Zoom on every Saturday, okay? So just invite 3 to 6 friends who you think that will really, you know, love the Thermomix, share it with them, and you can redeem this wonderful gift, okay? So thank you so much for joining us today. Your advisor who's invited you here today will be in contact with you, okay? Let us know if you have any questions, okay? We will be very happy to attend to your questions, all right? Have a very great weekend and take care and join us next week. See you, bye. And before we end our session, okay, I'd like to pass on to our presenters here today to show you their dish. Okay, thank you.
Okay. I guess we are you ready?
Yeah, okay, I'll go first. Okay, so the fish is ready. Okay, my veggie is ready. Look at the rice. Okay, the basmati rice. Look at that. Really good. Okay, and the sauce is ready. So I'm just going to pour it now on the salmon. Okay, smells really good. Okay. Okay. Make sure you try this recipe. You can substitute broccoli with other veggies if you like. Okay, so it took me like what, 17 plus 5 around, yeah, less than 25 minutes. Okay, so try this recipe, it's really yummy. Okay, so I'll see you next week. Okay, bye. I'll pass to Ting Ting.
Yeah. Like to I put it really close to the camera now to give you a close up view. This is the final result. It's really nice, tender. You can see that the sauce is actually enveloping every piece of the beef, right? Every slice of it, very nicely and evenly cooked, right? If I may just take a slice and show you the texture, okay? See, by just pulling it, it picks up easily. Okay. This is really like top-notch restaurant quality cooking, right? Really, seriously, whether it's beef today, it can be pork, it can be chicken, you can really achieve this result anytime at home. Do get your hands on your Thermomix as soon as possible and start cooking at home and have your family enjoy healthy meals at home effortlessly, like what Olivia has shared with you. All right, Olivia, Sunita, you have something to share before we leave?
No. All good. I'm just going to have my fresh orange.
All right. So great having everyone with us today.
Everyone. See you next week.
We'll have more sharing next week. If you have time this afternoon, you can also join our afternoon Chinese session. Bye and have a great weekend.
See you next week, everyone. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much. Yes, thank you.